Morning, everyone. Happy Friday. It's a Shakespeare Friday. Hey, guys, last month we did our first Shakespeare sonnet, and so many of you sent one, and I'm so proud of you. It was the 18th sonnet. I accidentally said it was the 23rd, but it was the 18th. But ironically, today we're doing the 23rd. So, again, congratulations to all of you who participated, Mark Pober, Matt Payne, Nick Road, Ashley, Pam, and guys, if I left you off, I am so sorry, but thank you. We have another one today. You have a month that you have throughout March to send in the sonnet. I just love to hear you do it. Doing sonnets, guys, is a great way but to continue to work on our voice, our diction. I work on them too. And Zuli, yes, I know Zuli, you did one. So thank you so much, guys. And why don't we get started with some moving and grooving, and then we'll get into our new sonnet challenge for March.
Hey, guys, I know there's a little bit of an issue with my costume. You are gonna dance in the forest and not sing.
Okay, good. Let's bring it to a stop. God, all right, good warm-up, good moving and grooving. Let's do some vocal warm-ups. Guys, you know, warming up is so important. I like the, one of the teachers, and I think of that I work with, says it kind of prepares, we're gonna do something different, right? We're going to do some Shakespeare, going to work on a new sonnet today. Like I said, I like to call it the pre-production before we act or perform. So let us just start with some breath work, and we'll do our breathing in, or inhale for 7, hold for 7, exhale for 8. We'll do that 5 times. Ready? Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7, hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Our fourth one. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And our final, inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Let's just shake. All right. Squint your nose around. Chew on that big wad of gum. It's so big, it's impossible to chew, really. So we're gonna doing about the diction today. So let's chew that around like we have a big wad of gum. Good. And let's blow air out of our lips. Good, good, good. All right. And we're gonna suck on that lemon. And open wide and eat that apple. And we're gonna suck on that lemon. Yeah. We're gonna open wide and eat that apple. Good, and we're gonna suck on that lemon and really suck on that lemon. Good, good. And open wide and eat that apple. Good, and now we're gonna do what I like to call the elevator. And that really low. And go up as high as you can in your range. All right, something like this. And come back down. All right. I'm taking this in the morning, but my voice is warming up too. All right, ready? And and good, it's not so much singing, but just, you know, as actors, we can talk in different parts of our range of our voice, right? We can talk really low, like a character, or more in a high-pitched voice. So always warming up our voice is so important. Let's do another elevator, please. And don't so much worry about singing it like a scale, but just allowing your voice to go up and then come back down. All right, but not so much singing. All right, good. Let's do some tongue twisters. Better biscuits. Better biscuits. Better biscuits. Bonnie's better biscuits. Bonnie's better biscuits. Bonnie's better biscuits. Bonnie's better biscuits. Silver salamanders shimmering in the sun. Silver salamanders shimmering in the sun. Silver salamanders shimmering in the sun. Good, guys. Okay, so, okay. All right, guys, good warm-up. Let me go. I'm making a couple changes to the silent challenge. We're going to work on it for 2 weeks, all right? The first week, we're just going to learn the lines. Learn them to get familiar with them. Yeah, I will send it out in an email, and also along with last night's homework, I'm sending an email out every Friday. All right, so again, you'll get this in the email today to work on it. Today we learn the verses. Next week we add the acting value. And then the last 2 weeks, our tape we will go back to insults. But I think it will be really fun. Sounds a little bit more challenging, but I'm gonna give you some time to work with it. So today, we're just learning the words and getting our mouths around the words. And also, guys, I'm doing the challenge along with you. So I'm learning the challenge too. I don't know all these sounds by heart. So I know I'm not off book yet on all these sounds. But I'm challenging myself to learn sounds along with you. All right? So today, we're working on the 23rd sonnet, which is a sonnet about the person who is so afraid to shut their love to somebody else. So they make analogies. Well, it feels like this. Well, it feels like that, you know, that they can't express their love. So this is what the song is about. Someone who is unable to express their love for someone. So we want it in four different sections, 3 or 4 verses and 1 or 2 verses, because a sonnet is always 14 verses, 14 lines rather. So we're going 4 lines, 4 lines, 4 lines, and 2 lines. Like I said, today we're just getting our mouths around the words, all right? And then I'll send it out. You can work on it. We'll come back and we'll add more at email you next week. Okay, so let us go to the first 4 lines. Okay. And like I said, guys, I'm learning it around with, along with you. Okay, ready? So repeat after me if you need to. Remember, we're just learning it today. As an unprepared actor on the stage, who with his fear is put beside his part, or some big thing replete with too much rage, his strength abundance weakens his own heart. So again, let's just repeat it. Repeat after me if you need to learn the lines. As an unperfect actor on the stage, who with his fear is put beside his part, or some fierce thing replete with too much rage, his strength abundance weakens his own heart. Good guy, let's learn that part one more time, and then we move on. As an unperfect actor on the stage, who with his spirit put beside his part, or some good thing replete with too much rage, his strength abundance weakens his own heart. So right now, the character you're comparing, it's like if an actor forgets his line, then he's afraid of to be on stage, and he has stage fright. This is what this feels like for me, not being able to express myself to you. So that's that. Cool. Let's go on to the second part. Again, we're just learning it today. There it is. So I, for fear of trust, forget to say the perfect ceremony of love's right. And in my own love's strength seem to decay, are challenged with bursting of my own love's might. Okay, I'll slow that down. You can get that around here. Get your words around, get your mouth around the words. But again, guys, I'm challenging myself as well. All right? All right, let's do it again. So I, for fear of trust, forget to say the perfect ceremony of love's right. And in my own love's strength seem to decay, are charged with bursting of my own love's might. Good. Good, good, guys. Good, good, good. Let's shake that out a bit. We have 2 more sessions just to get our mouths around today and work. And you guys are doing so great. All right, ready? All right, let's go on to the 3rd session. There it is. And guys, I'm learning this right along with you. Okay, ready? And action. Oh, let my books Bethimbe Eloquence. And down presages of my speaking breast, who plead without and look for recompense, sorry about that. So yeah, I'm going to do that again. I want you to hear and see how I learned to, and sometimes I stumble over words. It's not about perfection, it's about learning. Let's try that and rehearsing and doing it again and again. All right, so let's do that. It's a good discipline. Ready? Let's try this again. Oh, let my boats be then the eloquence and dumb presages of my speaking breast, who plead for love and look for recompense. More than that tongue, that more hath more expressed. Okay, good, let's try that. That's a mouthful. Okay, ready? Again. Oh, let my books be then the eloquence and dumb procedures of my speaking breast, who plead for love and look for recompense. More than that tongue, the more hath more expressed. Good, and let's do that one more time. Oh, let my books be then the eloquence and dumb presages of my speaking breast, who plead for love and look for recompense. More than that tongue, that more hath more expressed. Good, shake that out. Good, shake that out. And guys, again, I have my script. You know, you've seen the big thing, but I have the script behind me, because in front of me, because I'm learning it too. We're all doing this challenge together. I thought, cool, I have them to do it. I'm gonna do it too. So let's learn the last section. Here's the last section. And like I said, I'll send it out. Work on it. And next week, we'll start to put it together and put some fun, the emotional connection. All right. Today, again, we're just getting our mouth around the words. All right. Let's go to the final section. Oh, learn to read what silent love hath writ. To hear with eyes beyond the love's fine wit. Okay, let's do that again. Oh, learn to read what silent love hath writ. To hear with eyes beyond the love's fine wit. Let's try that one more time. Oh, learn to read what silent love hath writ. And hear with eyes belongs to love's fine wit. Good job, kid. Good job. Let's shake that out. So, what we're going to do now, one, just go through the whole thing. They'll pop up in front of you. We'll go through the whole thing. Just to hear the sound of it, then again, I'm sending it out. You can work on it this week, and next week, we'll bring it more together, add some acting and character value to it, and then again, you'll have to, the end of the month to send this in for our March Sonnet Challenge. So, let's just read through the whole thing. You can repeat after me if you need to. And as an unperfect actor on the stage, who with his fear is put beside his part, or some fierce thing replete with too much rage. His strength abundance weakens his own heart. So I feel just forget to say, the perfect ceremony of love's rite. And in my own love, strength seemed to decay. Are charged with bursts of mine own love might. Oh, let my book be then the eloquence and dumb procedures of my speaking breast, who plead for love and look for recompense. More than that tongue, that more has more expressed. Oh, learn to be that silent love that has writ. To hear with eyes belongs to love's fine wit. All right, good job, guys. Like I said, today it is. The preview, the cold feature feeding it through. Next week will add more value to it. But Simon does is a bit more challenging. That's why I want to break it up this way. But you will get this in the email tonight, along with Thursday's homework. I'm going to send an email out every Friday with everything that we did. And I know I said I would send one last night, but I didn't thought. I'll do it all on Friday. It will be the sonnet and your homework, your creative character work assignment for today, for Thursday. Guys, thank you for joining me today. I love it when you're with me. I love it when we can come together. So let us end it the very beginning with a little more moving and grooving. And as to this band, is a Scala, which is a woman's electric, if they like electric violin and electric cello, and the region 30 by classical music, and I celebrate because this woman's history month. Good work this week, guys.